Here's the jet I took out. It's a 160. I guess factory they come 130. The guy I bought it from, I bought this used just probably about a month ago. Sorry, I'm looking for my other jets. He had a White Brothers E-Series exhaust on it, and I guess the Motorsports place he bought it from, who installed it, put in a 140. Then they had the pilot jet jacked way out to like four turns out. So the guy I was talking to today that services the quads and tunes carburetors, because I was talking to him about jetting, he said if he ever has to go, he likes to keep it between 1.5 and 2.5 turns out on the pilot screw, which is this screw that's right here, which you'll usually adjust. And that's kind of for like, I guess, maybe like the idle mixture. I think that's like the low end type mixture. So he said if you ever have to go more than that, then he likes to rejet the pilot jet, which I believe is this one right here. I believe mine's fine. It's just that mine's popping in the mid-range, so I'm going to have to adjust my needle jet. Plus, I just took off the spark arrestor on the exhaust, so I'm going to jet it up just a little bit. I'm going to actually move up to 170. So I got 162.5. I just took out 160. This is 165. Yeah, so what he had put the exhaust on, and I... just added in the K&N cone filter into the airbox, and then the K&N power lid. Now the K&N power lid was meant to be run with the K&N cone filter in it, and it came with its own jets, and actually a K&N dry charger. And it came with a 160 jet, but that was intended just for the air filter and the power lid alone, not including the exhaust. So it came with a 160, so I'm going to put in a 170 because I got also the exhaust. So here's my 170. Put it back in your deal. And I'm not sure if there's a right way to do this, but I just, it's kind of a bitch. You gotta drop it in the hole. And we'll see how many tries it takes me here. Ready, screw it right back in there. And I guess they say since these are brass to not be too hard on them, you just kind of, when it gets, you just give a little tiny snug turn. You don't crank on it. Otherwise, I guess you can strip them out pretty easy. Strip the threads off the pilots themselves. I don't think they're going to go anywhere anyways. But at least if they do, you'll know how to take this back apart and put it back in. Now, on the... Shit, I need a new screwdriver. You need kind of a narrow screwdriver for this. And I have no idea what I used last time. I don't remember. Oh, yeah, yeah. I just got one of them Scheider mini deals from one of these kits where you got all the Allen wrenches and crap. Torx drivers. So that's what I was using. I'll put the flip bulb back on in a minute, but I know I'm going to have to cut this video short. So I'm going to turn it all the way closed, turn it clockwise, and then when it's snug, let's see, it's about right there. I already have it marked right there where fully closed is. So a lot of times the easiest way is to use a little paint pen or something too and mark it on here, that way you can see how many times you rotate it. But I'm going to go 2.5 out, so I'm going to go half, one, half, two, and a half. Slight more turn. All right, there you go. So 2.5 out. And so I'll try that and see how much better that works. So when you go to put this back in, remember your breather overfill tube that sticks out goes in a little slot right in here. So make sure you line that up when you're going to put it in.
actually doesn't go in the slot, it just goes around the side of it.
Close that, and then use your new stainless steel M4 socket head bolts. And you will be happy that you don't have to constantly worry about stripping out your threads. Just make sure you carry your little Allen wrench with you. I forget what size this is, but they usually sell them in the hardware section right next to your thing. And then, as you know, with the Z400s, you got all these containers in the back where you can keep extra tools, zip ties, and all that other crap. So I'm going to stop the video, and then I'm going to come back, and we're going to address changing the needle jet settings on the top. All right, thanks. All right, so I'm back. I've taken out my carburetors a little bit fully out so I can get to the top section and change the needle jet. Or, excuse me, just at least adjust the setting on it. Pretty much the only thing I had to do to get it out was there was a little rubber tube that I believe goes from the top of the engine or somewhere around there, like a breather that plugs in right here. I just pulled that off. There's no clamp holding it. And a lot of times with fittings like the one that comes from the gas tank to the front of this, sometimes the rubber gets stuck on there. If you got enough room and you push in on the hose, push towards, away, you know, the opposite direction from pulling it off, you push in on it, and that'll help loosen it, and then you can usually twist it off. This one, you didn't have very much room to do that, so I just used a flat screwdriver and kind of got underneath and kind of broke that little rubber stickiness seal off and then yanked it off. And then I removed the choke on it, and I'm kind of glad I did because there was a bunch of gunk that was in there. I don't know if it's corrosion or dirt or, you know, if something was getting past the O-ring, but it just goes in right here. It's a simple 14 millimeter, maybe 9/16 will work too, I don't know. But I just loosened it, and it just spins on its deal right there. And then you just yank it out, double check the needle on the end, make sure it's not all fouled up. I think all it does is just push plunger in anyway, so it's not that huge of a deal. Now, heed my warning on this because I decided to loosen this up and just check it out. I've never done this before. Like I said, I just got a quad a few days ago, and I'm kind of just going off of what I've seen on YouTube and whatnot, and a little bit of my own experience. When you loosen the two Phillips heads on here, hold the top down because there's a spring in there that holds down your needle jet. And if you don't do it like I did just a minute ago before I started recording, it's just two screws. The top will pop off, and your screws will go everywhere, and there's a little O-ring that sits right here, and it's probably some kind of breather to let air in, I'm guessing, so the diaphragm can move up and down. I don't know, I could be wrong. I could be talking out of my ass, but that's just my guess. I don't claim to be an expert. I'm just doing this shade tree style. Take your spring out, take your cap off. I just put it back on here so I don't lose it. I think you're supposed to be pretty gentle with your diaphragm, just making sure you don't tear it, because if you tear it, I think these are pretty expensive to replace. So pull it all the way out. There's your needle jet. It just sits in there. And as you pull on the throttle, this lifts up, and this little point on the end allows more fuel to flow into the carburetor along through your main jet. And that's why when you put the bigger main jet in, it's got a bigger opening, lets more fuel flow. And then obviously, if you can adjust this needle, it has certain slots on it, so you can adjust it so it sits up more time. That way there's constantly more fuel flowing in. Or you can adjust it down so you can have it run a little bit leaner. This is our first time together doing this, so bear with me if I screw some crap up. All right, I'm back, figured it out. All right, so again, heed my warning. I removed the diaphragm just to make it a little easier on myself. You don't have to do it, though, now that I've taken it off. But you just peel it off. There's a little clip that holds onto it from underneath. It just goes around like this, fits in a little groove. You just bend it into place over here. But like I said, you don't have to take it off. So there's a little clip that holds in the diaphragm. Diaphragm, I just pulled that up and over the edge. It's made out of rubber, so.